much as your body.
You know, it sure is, and I think there needs to be enjoyment in the kitchen. I don't know, I have fond memories of my family having fun in the kitchen. I think they're an Italian family, and they take, you know, food to a whole other level. So I think it's important, and I have little kids, so I try to make it as fun as I can.
You're a nutritionist, you're an author, you're a mother, you are a food and nutrition innovator, and the book is really beautiful.
Thank you.
I'm having a look at it there. I mean, it does. You, Carlene, every time we get together, I say, how is everything always so clean and white? Do you have a strategy for that?
Oh, my kids are not allowed in there. No.
I'm just kidding. We're looking at some of the beautiful photography, and really, I mean, there is a perception that healthy eating is incredibly expensive, and I think that you really want to get people back to the kitchen, but also to figure out how to do it affordably.
Yeah, you know what, it's not true, and that was one of my main goals with the book, is to, I grew up in Saskatchewan, so I wanted sure that the ingredients were common, that they were accessible, and that they were affordable. So there's a number of different strategies, like what we're seeing here is a corn soup. You know, you can buy frozen vegetables, they're inexpensive. Green frozen peas are very nutritious, very underrated, yet really affordable and available to everybody. And so you'd be surprised when you start eating from a box, a bag, a freezer bag, a can, it adds up. And so we can make nuts and seeds and canned food and beans go a long way in creating really nutritious, healthy, delicious dinners.
And if in fact cauliflower is on sale, that's the time to buy it, because Carlene is going to show us how to make an incredibly delicious pasta sauce.
Yeah.
Or a sauce for anything.
Well, sauce for anything, you use for dips, but I don't know about you, but pasta is always a big hit in my home. And like
whether it's in-laws or...
Yeah! And whether it's just myself or my husband eating or my children, I know pasta can always be a big hit, but we can't just eat white refined pasta all the time. So I look for ways to bring in more nutrition so that every bite counts. So even if my kids, out of three kids, one will love it, two, one will be, and the other will not like it at all. So I want to make every bite count. So using more superfood pasta, like red lentil pasta, black bean pasta, whole grains, really makes a difference. So this, like you said, when cauliflower's on sale, buy it extra, freeze it. You can put frozen cauliflower in smoothies, you can make soups, you can make sauces. So here in our, if you have a high power blender at home, it can be anyone, it doesn't have to be a Vitamix machine, but we kind of have the beginning of the ingredients and we accidentally turned it on. That's why I'm already blender.
Okay. The ingredients in the blender.
That's right, our leeks, garlic, of course, garlic tastes good with everything, some chicken broth, a little bit of coconut milk, and we're going to add the steamed cauliflower into the blender without spilling everywhere.
So this has just been vegetable broth if you want to make it vegan.
Vegetable broth if you want to make it vegan, that's right. And so you're just going to pop the lid and we're going to turn it on and we're going to blend it. And this is going to turn into this beautiful sauce here.
And why I love this recipe, Carlene, is it's perfect. So many people are dairy-free or trying to have a little bit less dairy. And this gives you that sense of creamy, delicious.
It's very creamy. If you want to thin it out, you can do that to make it into a soup, or you can keep it thick to make it into the pasta sauce. Add nutritional yeast, which is nice cheesy if you're doing vegan, and that Parmesan cheese.
Just toss, swirl, pour over your pasta. You can also pour it over spiralized noodles.
So really great, yeah, really great way. You can garnish it with some parsley. It looks delicious.
The whole display is delicious.
This is made in under 30 minutes. You know, and so we're all in a hurry, and, you know, whether you're single or family, everybody's in a hurry.
I'm so glad to mention that because I always think of single moms or dads out there who are trying their very best, but with time, and as we mentioned earlier, some, you know, the potential expense of buying fresh produce.
Yeah.
So your tips for that would be, as we mentioned, buy things when they're on sale and freeze them, or...
And then also planning ahead. So that's going to be a big way to make sure that you can do this Monday through Thursday, maybe. Take Friday off and order in some pizza. And also to just bring the cost down, because you're going to be buying on sale. You're going to be buying on bulk. You're going to make sure your pantry is stocked so that on Tuesday after work, you're not stuck buying some expensive meat or picking up takeout. So planning on Sundays, and I speak a lot about, the book is over 100 recipes, but I also include just a lot of really practical information, because I've been doing this for a long time from a nutritionist perspective and 11 years as a mother and a full-time working mom. So I needed to come up with some strategies that I know are going to work for everybody.
And in the book, you also share it was your own, you know, health challenge that led you to nutrition. We'll talk a little bit about that when we come back. And we'll also help you stock your pantry to make those Sunday planning sessions that much easier.